Hello everyone, this is Laura, and today I'm going to show you how we make raw sauerkraut. You can use any kind of cabbage. We've decided to use one red head and one green head. We want to shred it up, and that's going to be the first step, totally getting it all shredded. And this time we've made one batch before. It came out really great. So I said, I'm going to tape it this time. And so we have documentation of what we did and how it turns out. This batch, I want to add some garlic and onions in with the sauerkraut. I've seen many informational videos that say you can put any kind of vegetables in to ferment. And we're going to add these just with our sauerkraut. We have elected to chop our onion up and run it through the processor so it's shredded just like the cabbage. I suppose you could cut it and leave it any way you want as long as it fitted into the mason jar, the jar you want to use for fermentation. And there's our garlic. We're just going to chop it up and add it to our sauerkraut batch. The next step, after you have all your vegetables prepared, is you want to add salt. Now, the recipe is 3 tablespoons of salt per each 5 pounds of cabbage. I think we have about 1.5 pounds, so we're using about 1.5 tablespoons, or one tablespoon, I mean. A little over a tablespoon. And once you get the salt in, the fun part starts. You get to massage your cabbage. And then you massage your cabbage for as long as it takes. What happens is the salt causes the cell wall of the cabbage to break down and it will release a lot of juice. So as you go, it'll look like your cabbage reduces in size, becomes very soft and pliable, and real juicy. And this is good. This is what you want. This will help in the fermentation process. And this might take, you might have to massage your cabbage for up to 30 minutes. It just depends, you know, how long it takes to get all the surfaces coated with the salt and get it rubbed in. And that's what you're doing. So we'll bring you back when we have that done. Alright, as you can see, we've actually reduced 2 bowls of cabbage down into one. And that's all by massaging the salt into it. It only took about 10 or 15 minutes. Now we're adding in the onion and the garlic, which we've chopped up. And gonna mix that in. Okay, we've got our jars out. We're ready to pack our jars with the sauerkraut. Now, I've seen several ways to do this. Whatever you pack it in, you're going to have to pack it real solid and hold it down with weight. So it seems like it would be easier to use a big jar and hold it all down in one big jar, and then when it's done fermenting, pack it into separate jars. But we don't have a big jar, so we're going to use little jars. And we're just going to pack those up. While packing your jars, you have to pack it in there tight. You want to push all the air out and push out as much as possible. Just really pack it in there. And the order you do is you pack, and I want to add a little seasoning, but I want to do individual. I want to try dill in one of the jars and caraway seed in one of the jars. And I'm going to put that just on the top after we get it packed. And then you have to put a weight, some kind of weight, on the top to hold it down. And we have some little bitty jars we'll show you in a minute here. The next step, we have 3 jars packed. I seasoned 1 jar. I went ahead and put dill on the top. And 1 jar I put about 1/2 teaspoon of caraway seeds. And 1 I'm just leaving plain. The remainder we put into a blender. You want to put it in the blender. And I am going to, put all the juice in there. And you can even add a little bit of water, probably half a cup to start with. You don't want to have too much that you're going to have excess that won't go into your jars. You want to be able to get it all in your jars. So I would say no more than half a cup. And I'm going to put Dulse in mine, too. So let me get that.
How much of this?
Oh, just probably about... That's good. That's probably about a third cup packed Dulse. That's probably good. And then also going to put in... We actually have a little bit of juice left from our previous sauerkraut. So we're going to put that in instead of the water. We're going to use that for our juice. How's that look?
Looks a little better.
All right, you pour the liquid into each of your jars.
You gotta let it soak down in there too.
And you know you're gonna want to have to, you're gonna have to keep compressing the cabbage down the first day or so, and weigh it down, and then seal the lid on and leave it sit at room temperature. The first time we did it for 1 week, and it turned out perfect. It was really good. And there's the weights that go into the top. You fill them with water or the juice. I just compress the... All right, YouTube, we're back with our sauerkraut. It has been today's the eighth day, and our sauerkraut is ready, and we're going to do a taste test. If you remember, we made caraway and put caraway seed in one. We mixed the cabbage with the onion to start with, and we put caraway seed in one, dill in one, and garlic. We put more garlic in one of them than the rest, just in case. Okay, you ready to do a taste test? Which one is that one?
That one. Definitely dill. Very good. Very, very good.
Sour?
Mm-hmm. That's good. I like it. Let's try this one. Let's say that must have the caraway seed in. So we'll go with that. This one's in caraway. Has very distinct flavor.
But good.
Very good. I like it. And I hope you guys like garlic because I can smell this one.
Probably don't want to eat that if you got to go in public, huh?
Very good. I like them all three.
Good experiment. I'll have to repeat that, huh?
Yep. They're all good.
All right.
And all way sour. Ooh.
Well, I hope everybody enjoys making their own sauerkraut, and use your imagination and experiment. We'll probably come up with some different recipes ourselves.